The LD2410 Human Presence Sensor is a great working device that is small, very sensitive, and it can catch even the slightest human movement. It is also super cheap, costing less than $4, and it is easy to use. Thanks to the LD2410 sensor, you can make great presence-based home automations. This sensor can work over Bluetooth with Home Assistant natively without any modifications, as I'm describing in both of these videos of mine. And here in the Bluetooth is the Achilles heel of this sensor. What if you don't have Bluetooth adapters on your Home Assistant device? Or you have it, but the Bluetooth coverage is bad on the place that you want to put the LD2410 human presence sensor. Do not worry, I will show you a quick, easy and effective solution for that Bluetooth problem using the ESP32 board as a middleman. The ESP32 board is also costing under $4 and it will be used to communicate with your Home Assistant over Wi-Fi and at the same time with your LD2410 sensor. This is an effective, fast and simple way to extend your wireless coverage, preserving all the benefits that the LD2410 sensor provides. To make this possible, I will install ESP Home software on the ESP board, which is not hard at all, and I'll show you how to do the same. But before that, here is what is needed to make this DIY project a reality. From the hardware part, you need at least one LD2410 sensor. It can be any model, with or without Bluetooth, and any form factor. Next, you need an ESP32 board, like D1 Mini ESP32 or similar. One data micro USB cable is also needed to power up the D1 Mini and to upload the ESP Home software on it, using it. You will also need several jumper wires or something similar. It is possible to solder the wires directly to the both boards, or you can use a breadboard before that to test this setup. And here is the best time to mention that soldering is not scary and you can hardly break something. So give it a try, or as a last resort, ask a friend to help you. Of course, for the soldering, you need a soldering iron and some tin wire. If you don't have some of the above mentioned devices and items, don't worry, I'll leave some affiliate links to everything that is needed in the video description. For the software part, you need a working Home Assistant with add-on store. Home Assistant will be your main smart home hub and will allow you to create home automation based on the information that the LD2410 sensor will provide. As a simple example, you can turn on the lights and don't turn them off until human presence is detected in an area of your choice. To learn more about Home Assistant and the different official installation types, plus one super simple way to get started on a PC, feel free to join my webinar, where I'll talk exactly about that. The webinar is free and you can reserve your seat right now from my website, automatelike.pro/webinar. Apart from the Home Assistant, you also need ESP Home dashboard that will help you to install ESP Home software on the ESP32 board and then to manage your ESP Home devices afterwards. One of the easiest way to get ESP Home dashboard up and running is to install it as one-click add-on from the Home Assistant add-on store. There are some other ways and they are well described in this video of mine. Next is the wiring. Here is how I managed to wire everything. I connected the VCC pin on the LD2410 to the VCC pin on the D1 Mini ESP32. Then I connected the ground pin on the LD2410 sensor to the ground pin on the D1 Mini ESP32. After that, I connected the RX pin on the LD2410 to the TX pin on the D1 Mini ESP32. And finally, I connected the TX pin on the LD2410 to the RX pin on the D1 Mini ESP32. And the final result is looking like that. After that, I connected the D1 Mini using a regular data micro USB cable to the device where Home Assistant and ESP Home are running. One important remark, connecting the device like that is only needed during the initial ESP Home installation. Once ESP Home is up and running, you can move your D1 Mini ESP32 and your LD2410 sensor wherever you wish. As long as you power them using an USB port or USB power adapter, and if you are in a place with Wi-Fi coverage, everything will work. So, I connected the future human presence sensor to my home assistant device, in my case it is a Raspberry Pi 4, and I created a new ESP home device. Attention here, I have not installed it yet, because I want to edit the ESP home configuration first. As ESP home configuration, I will put the following YAML code. This code is provided to you thanks to the ESP Home documentation and Larry from my subscribers who wrote me about it. Of course, you can get the code from the video description for free, exactly as my smart home glossary. Anyways, once I have the code pasted and my sensor and ESP32 board connected, I'll hit save and install. After several minutes, I'll be able to see from the ESP Home logs some promising data. It seems that my LD2410 and ESP32 based human presence sensor is working as expected. The next step is to add the LD2410 in my home assistant, and that is super easy. I'll just go to my home assistant integration section and I will find it how to discover there. The final step is to start creating some useful home automations, like this simple one. If presence is detected, turn on the lights. And here is a challenge for you. Can you please share in the comments, are you going to try this approach? And if yes, what will be your first automations that you'll try? It can become a great source of ideas if more of you are willing to share something. Thanks for watching, I'm Kirill, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!